Sir, at the outset, I extend a warm and hearty welcome to Honorable Chief Minister, who is attending the SLBC meeting for the first time. We are indeed honored to have the Honorable Chief Minister with us to guide us in the deliberations. I have equal pleasure in extending a very warm welcome to all of you for the 172nd meeting of SLBC of Andhra Pradesh. Today's meeting is convened with a special focus on agriculture sector in view of the recent floods and heavy rains in Andhra Pradesh. You are all aware that this year the monsoon was generally good across the state and farmers were indeed expecting a bumper kharif harvest. Unfortunately, due to the heavy and incessant rains from 29th of October to 4th of November and due to Jal cyclone from 5th of November to 8th of November, many areas of the state were affected by floods and heavy rains. The state government declared 483 mandals in 13 districts as affected by floods and heavy rains during this period. The vagaries of monsoon did not stop there. Between 5-12 and 9-12, due to depression in the Bay of Bengal, additional 124 mandals are affected in 4 districts. The magnitude of loss to standing crops and animal life has been enormous. As per the government estimate, crops in about 16.28 lakh hectares were affected, involving 31.77 lakh farmers. The loss of crops is by of damage to the standing crops as also to the crop that is already harvested and ready for marketing. The SLBC has immediately responded to the gravity of the situation and had advised all the lead district managers and controlling authorities of respective banks in the first fortnight of November 2010 to initiate relief measures in the affected areas. A special steering committee meeting was also conducted on 2012 to discuss about the reschedulement of loans. All the banks and lead district managers were once again advised to initiate relief measures in terms of RBI guidelines on natural calamities. As per the broad action plan approved by the steering committee, banks have in principle agreed to reschedule the crop loans of the farmers in the affected areas and to extend further finance for crop production wherever fresh crops are being raised. And you are all aware that Reserve Bank of India has communicated comprehensive and updated guidelines to be followed by banks in the case of natural calamities. SLBC has already brought the guidelines to the notice of all the banks and lead district managers. The LDMs were advised to review the situation in the respective districts by conducting special DCC meetings immediately to finalize district-specific action plan. Banking system has done a commendable job in the state in the field of agriculture and rural development. On behalf of SLBC, I would like to assure Honorable Chief Minister that all the banks will act proactively at this hour of need and extend all the required assistance to the needy. I appeal to all my banker colleagues to pay the required attention to the problems of the distressed to overcome the adverse impact on the rural economy. I once again appeal to all my banker colleagues to immediately sensitize all their field level functionaries to review the situation at the ground level in their operational areas so as to extend necessary relief measures to the affected people. The prevailing situation warrants urgent action by all of us on a war footing. Coming to the lending under agriculture sector, as per the data received by SLBC, banks have disbursed crop loan of 16,372 crores as against a target of 17,473 crores for the Kharif season, with an achievement of 93.70% of the target. Under agricultural term loan and allied activities, banks have disbursed 8,606 crores as against a target of 8,609 crores for Kharif 2010, achieving nearly 100%.